I'm trying to gear up for Thursday night's football game. Jets and Broncos. Now I understand why guys put money on a game that they have no interest in watching. And I tried to put a bet on this game with Fritzy that I was going to take the Jets in 3.5. And Fritzy doesn't want to take me up on that. Yeah, Paulie.
All right, let's do this. I got a guy. Let's put...
No.
As a group.
Nope, can't.
None of your money, Dan.
No, it doesn't matter. I invest in it if I know that even you're betting on it.
But then you'll watch it, won't you?
Yeah, but then I...
We're not recommending anyone follow our betting tips. Like, you shouldn't follow anyone in the sports
media. This is like a gateway drug, Paulie. This is how it starts back again.
I'm making the bet.
I'm in a 12-step recovery program from gambling. I went into a recovery program for fantasy football. And I'm not joking. I was in so many leagues. I didn't know who I was rooting for or against. I'd walk by a room when I was at ESPN, and they'd be holding a draft. And I would walk in just so I could be in the draft. I had to stop because fantasy was taking over my life. Gambling take. You guys might be surprised, but I sort of have that personality, that gene, that something might take over my life. And I can't have you put 50 on the game on Thursday night.
Okay, I'll put 100.
Let's put 100 on it.
Yeah. We'll take the Jets and the over and we'll cash it in.
Yeah. You go back to Ross Tucker. Remember what Ross said on Monday? He thought that the Ravens are going to win by double digits. I don't want to be that guy that gives advice on gambling. Even when I give my Super Bowl pick, I hate it because people go, oh, yeah, you told me to pick the Ravens. I didn't tell you to pick anybody. And I never get credit. That year I picked Seattle and Denver in the Super Bowl and Seattle to win the Super Bowl. And it played out that way. I got no credit. Then I picked the damn Chargers and all I hear is, you picked the Chargers. I go, you're right, I did. Yeah, see.
I think I'm supportive of the Paul Papp's gambling guru.
I don't know anything, but I'll
movement.
Wait, what?
Throw $50 down. Big deal. Jets Broncos.
This is how it starts.
Nobody gets hurt.
And then you lose. Now you're down $55.
We'll chase it with LSU on the weekend.
Chase it over the weekend.
They're mad. They're recap. Rebacked.
Next thing you know, you're betting on Sunday.
26 minutes into hour two is the day our lives.
No. Yes, McLovin.
Did we pick a side here? And how on earth you predicted the outcome of this particular game?
I'm taking the Jets. For entertainment purposes only.
The line is even right now.
It
so you're basically picking the winner. The over-under is 40, which would be...
Wait, I thought I was getting 3.5.
You missed your window.
Everybody followed what I was saying yesterday.
And that's where it changed the line.
All right, I'm going to take Denver. Who's starting? Brett Rippon?
Correct.
And he's not... Mark Rippon is not his dad. That's his uncle. Is that right, McLovin?
Yes. Yeah, okay. Which is a discovery to there. That's like the one fact that everyone's talking about at this game.
Brett Rippon. Yeah, I thought it was his dad.
Boise State, right?
Yeah, yeah. Didn't Merrill Hodge's son play quarterback at Boise State, or was it BYU?
BYU, I believe.
Yeah, I remember watching Merrill Hodge's son play. God, I'm old. Now I'm watching the kids of the guys that I watched. Yes, Paulie.
You know, the one I heard someone talking on sports radio today saying if the Titans...
I told you not to listen to sports radio.
I know. It was betting talk.
Okay.
That if the Steelers-Titans game goes on as planned and the Titans don't get a normal week schedule, they're going to bomb, you know, put a lot of money on the Steelers. It's a sure thing the Steelers are going to win. That seems to me like a sucker bet where I would go the other way and bet on the Titans because no one would think they'd win.
But also... That game's off the board.
Right.
I don't know if it's...
It's currently off the board.
But they put it back on the board if they decided they were going to play that game on Sunday?
As long as they know who's starting, if the quarterback's in, yeah.
Boy, that... I would... Well, maybe I shouldn't be surprised that Vegas would have that back on the board. If the Titans can't practice, I wonder what the line would be. If they factor that in, that the Titans can't practice in pads facing the Steelers... And is that in Pittsburgh?
Tennessee.
Oh. How would you feel if you're Pittsburgh, you have to go to Tennessee, given what's going on there? Yes, McLovin.
There has been some examples of teams not being able to practice. Like the NFL screwed the Saints over a bunch of times because of weather, or at least once because of Katrina.
Oh, yeah.
Just made them.
It just feels like the NFL is going to plow ahead, as they have with everything this year. They're just going to somehow, some way... They're playing football. you know, that they're going to get this game in.